So let's say you're on an African safari. You can hear the unique sounds of the open lands, you can see giraffes off in the distance, and you can feel the warm breeze on your face. And then you turn around, and you see this. What do you do? So chances are, if you see a lion that's about to eat you, your body is gonna respond in one of two ways. Fight. Or flee. Essentially, your brain's automatic response to threat kicks in, and you feel a rush of adrenaline, and you prepare to either fight for your life or run like heck the other direction. And there's very little thought involved in this immediate response. And that's normal. It's a biological system that's adapted over time to help humans survive mortal peril. But what happens if that lion shows up at home every night? What if it's lurking around every corner of your neighborhood? What if suddenly nowhere feels safe? What happens to your body then? So these types of persistent, chronic, and intense experiences of threat result in what scientists call toxic stress. As the name implies, these long-lasting and repeated experiences of stress can result in toxic damage to the brain and the body. And over the past few decades, there's been extensive research done on the effects of these toxic stress experiences for the brain and body. So one pretty well-known series of studies done on this topic are the Adverse Childhood Experiences, or ACEs, studies. In these studies, researchers asked over 17,000 adults about the types of adverse and stressful experiences they had had in their childhoods. And these experiences included things like abuse, neglect, mental illness, or substance use. So over two-thirds of study participants reported at least one adverse childhood experience, and one in five participants reported three or more adverse experiences. Then researchers correlated the number of adverse childhood experiences people reported to the number of health problems later in life, including things like alcoholism, mental illness, and heart disease. And here's the kicker. The more adverse childhood experiences people reported, the more severe and numerous their health problems were later in life. Now, here is where I give the caveat that this study is correlational in nature, and thus we can't really determine if and how these particular adverse experiences cause these later health outcomes. But I will say that this is one in a long series of studies that have found various physical and mental health problems related to early experiences of chronic stress. So some research with rats has found that sustained exposure to highly stressful situations can result in memory and learning impairments, as well as suppressed immune system functioning. And genetic research has found that exposure to chronic stress can actually change the way that your genes are expressed across your lifetime. And some research suggests that if pregnant women experience extreme stress during their pregnancy, that it can actually alter how their baby's stress regulation system develops. So the evidence is pretty clear that exposure to chronic and toxic stress early in life and really across the lifespan can be very detrimental to health and well-being. But it's important to note that not all children or people exposed to toxic stress will necessarily have health issues. So how do we decrease the stress that's experienced by children? So obviously, it's impossible to remove all experiences of stress from children's lives. And as I've discussed previously, it's actually beneficial for us to experience some stress. But I have a lot of ideas about how we as a society can reduce experiences of toxic stress for children, and I'm sure I'll get into them in future videos, but I'll start with something that's probably the most straightforward. Relationships. It all starts and ends with relationships. Research has found that when children can rely on caring and responsive adults around them, that it lessens their biological response to stress. Children are able to cope with stress more effectively when caring adults are present who can help teach them how to cope with those experiences. If young people can have one, just one, caring adult who they can trust and rely on, then their experiences of stress can go from being toxic to being tolerable. Now, how we support parents and teachers and professionals to build those relationships with kids, yeah, that's a topic for a whole series of videos, so stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, I've been collecting stories from a lot of you about the people in your lives who make a positive difference and who you rely on when you feel hopeless. I've gotten some great responses to these questions, so many thanks to those of you who have already responded. If you haven't and you want to, take a crack at these two questions and submit them via Tumblr or Twitter with the hashtag BRGStory, and I'll start sharing some of these in some future videos. I've also got a playlist that I put together of some great videos that talk about the nitty-gritty of the biology of stress and what it does to our brains and bodies, so be sure to check that out. And remember to click like if you liked it, and subscribe if you want to see more. And as always, thanks for watching.